I wish you could come and visit us sometime here at the New Life Evangelistic Center and just see how many hurting and homeless people continue to come in every day, every night, all year long. And what a big difference you can make as you become involved as a Club 24 member. You need to see it. You need to get to know the people. You need to understand, not just so that you can help them, so that you can experience help in your own individual life. Broaden your perspective. Enrich your life by including those that are hurting and those that are homeless. These opportunities await you here. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. Listen to the politicians who use the homeless for political purposes over and over and over. You'd think they totally solve all the problems. They talk about their 10-year plans. They have their meetings. They bring out all the media, and they say they're doing all these programs for all these people. And then people begin to believe that stuff. And then they see somebody that's actually out on the streets, somebody's really homeless, and they think, well, all that stuff going on, something must be wrong with those people. It's not. It's with the fact that the programs, they set up so many different restrictions, people can't get into those programs. They benefit the politicians, the bureaucrats, the fat cats, and the rest of them out there. But many of the people are left to fall through the cracks, which only intensify their depression, their frustration, their sense of hopelessness. That's why here at New Life Evangelistic Center, we are not a part of the Mayor's Network for the Homeless. We do not receive city, state, or federal dollars. We come before you as a member of the body of Christ and say, join us in making a big difference for good and become a Club 24 member so we can help anyone and everyone through the love of Christ and have nowhere else to go. And many are in that situation. You're one of them. Tell us your name.
My name is Valentia.
Valentia. Had you tried other places?
Yes, I called that 211 referral, but they said I should have kids. And since I don't have kids, they said I should be court ordered for Salvation Army to get in one of their homeless shelters.
And you had to get a court order to get in there.
Well, I'm not on alcohol or drugs, sir.
So
I'm doing Christ.
See, that's what happens when they start taking the federal money. They get money for drugs. They get money for alcohol. They have to get a court order to get into one of those. Or they might give it, in some cases, you said for the children, so you don't want to go out and have, you don't want to go out and get drunk, you don't want to go out and do drugs, and you don't want to go out and have kids.
Nope.
So
they're grown.
You are.
So they say empower yourself and educate. Well, that too, thank you, Lord, for my associate degree and 5.5 years of work skill workshop school. Mm-hmm. Trust for Success Network going places. Thank you. I finished them all. Where is the work?
So the system, so again, you listen to all this propaganda that the politician tells you. The mayor running for re-election says he's taking care of the homeless. Come on, you're going to believe that kind of stuff. He gets millions and millions of dollars from big developers and from special interest groups that he rewards with special contracts. And then he comes along and says he's taking care of the homeless and he's dealing with crime, and that couldn't be further from the truth. And we see the people on a daily basis as totally different than what the mayor's saying and the others are saying. You go to St. Louis County, they say, well, we're spending money on this. You go over to Illinois, all over, and the people are left to fall through the cracks, and they make them feel like something's wrong because, number one, they don't have a court order to get into the Salvation Army federal funded programs for drugs and alcohol. They don't have little ones. I don't know what else they tell you.
Well,
you got to be mentally ill, I guess.
Yes, you can have bipolar when you finish college, human service and addiction college.
You got to have something to, but
right.
Anyway, you fell through the cracks. How did you end up coming here?
My mother is here. Mm-hmm. She lives in Wellston, mm-hmm. and she do have Section 8. But unfortunately, her house isn't big enough to house me or she will lose her Section 8.
So she's in St. Louis County. St. Louis County doesn't have any shelters.
Right. And if you stay out on the street, the police said that if you don't get in a shelter, they will lock you up.
And that's the only kind of shelter. You say, well, yeah. Maybe that's the only way I get any shelter then. But
right.
The police did tell you that.
Well, a young lady on the light rail uh-huh. train told me about Larry Rice uh-huh. and that I can come down here. So it was about 9:30 that night. I didn't know which way I was going, nor did I have money to take the train. So I just kept walking. By 9:30, I got down here. I was cold and hungry. And I thanked the Lord that I didn't have any more kids or wasn't on drugs
yeah.
because God said, repent. And it takes a lot of work to stay sober.
And so we were open all night long.
So I came here.
And we were open all night long.
And you gave me a place to live. And not only did you give me a nice warm bed to sleep and cover, you gave me food and clothes to cover my body. And I thank you for that.
And we are able to do that because of all of you that are praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. And all of you that are getting involved, and I want you to feel the joy. I want you to feel the sense of fulfillment as your club membership because of what you're doing. You made it possible for this place to be open. So this woman that literally had nowhere at all to go was able to come in because it's not just open at certain times. It's open all night long. So she's able to come and have a place. You're a part of that. Now, if you haven't gotten involved, please do it now and get involved. Become a Club 24 member. It's only 80 cents a day, $24 a month. Please pray for the work of the New Life Evangelistic Center. We call this program Here's Help, not only to help ladies such as this, but to help you, to help so many that have their individual lifestyles, but you've locked out all the poor, you've locked out the homeless, you've locked out the needy. You may be caught in the great big rat race from 8 to 5. You got a job, okay, thank God for it, and you run. You come through the same thing that even if you win the race, you still feel like a rat. Or you may feel like you're in a gutter, which is a grave with both ends knocked out, and a real rut, that's what a rut is, a grave with both ends knocked out. Let God bring you out of it. Experience His fullness by helping other people. Wow. Well, you said you were on the Metrolink. You didn't know where you were going. Did the police tell you or somebody tell you that if you lay down there, they're going to arrest you if you lay down on the sidewalk to sleep?
That was in Wellston. So they said that. And then a lady told me, just keep walking. You'll get to Larry Rice. And then she asked what religion I was. I told her I've been Catholic, Lutheran, Baptist, Sabbath, Saturday, Methodic Jews, which was a great experience in life.
Well.
But I wonder what kind of Christian I really am, because I'm homeless. No one would give you that job with that education. But New Life Evangelism Center didn't care what my religion was. They took me in.
You're a child of God. You've been made in the image of God. You're someone Thank special you. To Him. And we have an obligation to reach out if we say that we're followers of Jesus Christ to help you, because that's Thank what you. He told us to do. And Thank we want you. To do it. You know, Jesus went about restoring people back to their image. They were made in the image of God. They wanted to stone that woman caught in adultery. Jesus said, whether without sin, let them cast the first stone. He said, go and sin no more. He loves you. He's received you. He said, as we receive you, we're receiving Him.
Yes.
That's what He told
Thank
us that
you.
We do it.
Thank
he said,
you.
As oft you've done to the least of these, even so you've done to me. Read it for yourself. It's right there in the Bible, folks. Jesus has told us to do this, and there are so many that are homeless, hurting, in need. Have you seen all of them? As you're staying here,
it's
all
It's a
the
lot.
People?
I'm actually joined that 30-day program
Transitional
here.
Transitional housing program.
And I like that program. I'm able to give back as my stay in here and help other women to come, but we are overcrowded up there.
Tremendous. A lot of
yes.
people in there.
Yeah. And in the after-night program, there's just not enough room for them.
You see, totally packed up where the women and children are. And then downstairs, we moved already off all the chairs and putting mats down there, and we try to find them.
Yeah.
And we just ask you to just keep praying for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. There's many of them, aren't there? Did you know there were so many of them that were homeless like that?
No. But it's a big epidemic with the government political statement because it's in San Diego, Texas, Minneapolis.
Yeah.
All over Wisconsin, this homelessness is just a big political laugh or joke or something, but we're all God's children.
What did it mean to you when we all gathered together for prayer? Prayed
oh,
on him, huh?
Thank you, Lord. You have not forgotten me. You have not forsaken me. You promised to restore our lives, and you say that our work is not in vain to worship and praise you and glorify and magnify your name. He has given us hope. Hope not to go commit suicide, not to believe your labels and tabs, or not to go get crack cocaine, alcohol, a court order. You got to get in trouble just to put a roof over my head with a college degree or 2 college degrees, yet there's no work. Thank you for accepting me and doing the real work of Christ. Not everyone can do it, I suppose.
It's because of you, caring people like you. I told you this program is called Here's Help. We want to help you to discover the joy of getting beyond yourself, broadening your horizons, and getting involved in the lives of hurting people, and know you're making such a big difference for good. What a blessing you are, each and every one of you, in the lives of so many that are in need. And again, we want to give you that opportunity. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. And I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center, because we want to help anyone and everyone. We do not receive city, state, or federal dollars or United Way dollars. We reach out and help anyone, and we freely share that there is hope. Christ is risen. We don't hold back when it comes to the spiritual, mental, or physical. We help the total person because that's what the Lord has told us to do. Tom is joining me at this time. And Tom, what does that mean to you that we're willing to help anyone and everyone?
It saved my bacon because I was in pretty sad shape. Just two nights ago, I was out on the road hitchhiking, and the rain came. And at that point, I was already pretty frustrated and pretty hungry and about to get pretty muddy on top of it all. And I found myself up on 270 with the original thought of moving back to Colorado, where I've been living the past many years, after having visited family back in Ohio, where I grew up. And then yesterday, I ran out of steam. I realized that I wasn't getting anywhere and didn't feel as though I was going to go anywhere. And so I reached out for help, which is not...
How did you do that? How did you get to this place?
I basically flagged down a nice lady deputy.
Okay.
At one of the little convenience stores out there on the highway.
A deputy sheriff?
Yeah.
And flagged her down?
And said, I'm in trouble. You know, I'm physically hurting. I feel spiritually just exhausted. And she got a hold of somebody who knew of the ministry here. And this young man brought me in and dropped me off last evening. And it was very non-judgmental. You know, I've heard some of your interviews with others here today, and basically through no fault of their own, you know, the times, the conditions, loss of loved ones have put them in a homeless situation with very little resources. My story's not so clean.
But a few years back, did you ever think you'd be homeless up to this point?
No, I was always pretty resilient living out there in Estes Park, Colorado. Even the 11 months I lived in a tent on a hillside, you know, I wasn't homeless.
Yeah,
because I was actually quite comfortable, and you know, I had all the proper gear to make that Colorado experience happen. But then when I hit the road this past May, I just couldn't seem to alight anywhere. I was like a bird looking for its nest, and it blew away in a storm. And even after I got back to Ohio to spend time with my family over the holidays, I just kept on the road. I've probably been in 20 different states in the period of time. And pretty challenging weather, to say the least. God's people have been rather generous. I mean, the money comes and the money goes.
Yes.
But it was just always that unsurety of, am I going to eat today? Or is that something I maybe ought to plan on for tomorrow? And I did. I called out to the Lord. I said, I'm done. I just can't go any further.
You reached the end of yourself.
I reached the end of myself. There was a time many years ago, Pastor, where I was working in a mission in Reno, where I was actually part of the crew taking care of the least of my brothers. And it was the most satisfying time of my life. You know, full-time church services. Full-time reaching out in a non-judgmental way. It didn't matter how you got there, you were there. And I believe that's the way the Lord looks at us. Of course, He already knows how we got there. You know, there's nothing, no surprises with the Lord's knowledge of each one of us. And so I just wanted to get in. I'm in the 30-day program.
The transitional housing program, yes.
At this point.
Is this an answer to your prayers?
This is an answer to my prayers.
Giving you a chance to really just say, Lord, where do I go from here? What do I do? And be in Christian fellowship with other people.
To be part of the solution rather than part of the problem. Financially, I can't really do much for somebody else. But I know in a few days' time, because the Lord is good, I'll be feeling better. I won't be so scared. And I'll be able to reach out and be part of somebody else's recovery.
Every person reaches a point where they just get totally burned out, tired out, worn out, just says, I can't take it no more. And you reach that point. You call out unto God, and through a miraculous chain of events, He brought you here to New Life Evangelistic Center. It's all of you that make it possible for the doors to be open, for us to be able to be that answer for prayer. All of you that are praying right now, all of you that have teamed up with us here, all of you that are sharing those special, much-needed one-time gifts right now at this moment, and those of you that are volunteering, what an answer to prayer you are. And that's what we want to do, is give you an opportunity to see the difference you can make in people's lives. And as you've indicated, you also now want to be part of, again, the solution, not the problem. People don't get involved in helping anybody. They're part of the problem. And that's what we do. We give people, we have a very open door policy here, that we don't see you as the problem and we have the answers and you're the client and we're the social worker. No, we say you're part of the family. You're received, given opportunities to volunteer, to help out, even when you're staying here, to help others in need. How does that make you feel?
It makes me feel like, as you said, it's an answer to prayer, because on my own, I wasn't doing a very good job. Mm-hmm. I needed a structured environment, mm-hmm. which was Christ-based.
Yes.
I've heard mentions of government programs and that, well, you've got to be this or you've got to be that, pigeonholing people, and mm-hmm. therefore you can get the government funds. Everything I've heard just in the 24 hours that I've been here, Pastor, has been, it's all about what Jesus would do. And I just feel as though he moves in a great way here. Like I said, I'm not familiar with St. Louis. Mm-hmm. Maybe came through on a bus once mm-hmm. or twice in my lifetime. But already, I've seen this incredible need. I've been living up in the mountains. You just don't see a whole lot of mm-hmm. homeless people. Out there, I was Daniel Boone. Here, mm-hmm. I'm homeless. Mm-hmm. And to see everybody coming in for the dinners last night, and people coming in all night long. I was up in the general mm-hmm. Population, mm-hmm. so to speak. And there were several new individuals coming in the middle of the night mm-hmm. because they had reached mm-hmm. the end of their rope for survival. You know, I was blessed that I still had enough left in me to realize that this doesn't have to be the end, that this is the beginning. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm not going to give up, because the Lord doesn't give up. And I've got a beautiful family back east who I've been lying to and telling them I'm fine, because I wouldn't want them to worry. But in a few days, I'll be looking forward to making a call to my son, Tom, mm-hmm. and saying, hey, your dad's not really in bad shape, because here's where I'm at right now. So I'm grateful. I'm grateful to the Lord for giving me some humility for a change. And for everybody here that's just been so gracious and the generosity. We had an incredible little dinner service last night, I don't want to say. And the woman, the deaconess that came in, I mean, she was just so fired up with the Lord that I was singing songs I didn't know that I even knew how to sing, because you just felt that mm-hmm. that good emotion coming out. So, no, I'm not scared anymore. Mm-hmm. I'm still hurting. You can't sleep mm-hmm. under too many underpasses at 58 years old in the wintertime without pulling a muscle or two. Mm-hmm. But I know that I'll be blessed and really look forward to being part of the family here.
Yes, you are making such a big difference in the lives of so many different people. Continue to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. When people come to the end of themselves and the prodigal sons and daughters need a home to go home to, and they don't have a family, and they're not there, where the Lord's bringing them from all over the United States, opportunities for us to share Jesus. What a mission field you're a part of. But again, we need a major miracle here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Tremendous financial needs. It costs $13,000 to $15,000 every day. And the donations have been far below that. So again, please go to God in prayer and ask the Lord to do that. I know He's speaking to a lot of His people's heart. The problem is they're not listening or they're not responding. So please respond as He nudges your heart and share that much needed gift with New Life Evangelistic Center. P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Lou's joined us at this time. And Lou, what's it meant for you to be here at New Life Evangelistic Center?
You mean what does it mean for me to be here?
Uh-huh.
It means a great deal for me to be here.
Does it really?
It does. Being homeless is not an easy battle for me at all. So this is my helpmeet here.
Is it?
Yes,
I know you
is.
Were in our transitional housing program. You want to continue on. How's it helped you during that transitional housing as you continue on in your training here?
Well, it has helped me to gain some stability. Mm-hmm. It has helped me to grow in numerous of ways. Mm-hmm. You know, when you settle down and you're on solid ground, then you can focus more on what you're really trying to move toward here.
That's helped you. You ended up homeless.
Yes, I did.
How did that happen to you?
Well, things happen. Life. Uh-huh. Life happens to us all. Family.
And you didn't have any place at all to go?
I did not have any place at all to go.
How did you end up coming to this place?
Well, again, family. Mm-hmm. And so when you don't have a place to go, you go where you can go. You go where the availability lies.
And somebody told you about this?
Of course.
Uh-huh. And you've made new friends, made new family?
Oh, I did. I did. Of course I did. We are family here at New Life.
And you feel like you're part of family?
Oh, of course.
It's helped you grow in your faith? You feel closer to Jesus now?
I do. I do, in more ways than one.
You do feel more ways than one, closer to Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
How has it helped you grow in the Lord?
Well, it has helped my faith. Mm-hmm. In numerous of ways, you know, expectancy, growth.
What are some of your dreams for the future?
That's an interesting question, mm-hmm. and a question I can't answer.
You can't. You're taking it one day at a time.
One day at a time, of course.
One day at a time. And you help make it possible for her to take one day at a time as you continue to keep praying for Lou here, and the mothers, the children, the veterans, the hurting, the homeless, the people that the Lord is bringing in from all over. I thank God for those of you that are praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. And I ask you to discover the joy that comes from making a big difference for good. As a Club 24 member, you'll be invited to special events that we have here at New Life Evangelistic Center. We have some special gifts for you, but even more important than that, you will know that you and your sharing, and again, it's not a whole lot. It's only like 80 cents a day. You put instead of going out and buying that bottle of water or buying that soda or buying that hamburger, you drop that 80 cents a day in that cup, in that bowl, and at the end of the month, you take the $24 and you send it here to New Life Evangelistic Center. And I'm asking you to join us in praying for 1,000 new club members. God is a miracle-working God. We're putting the invitation out to all the residents of Belleville. We're sending out mailings there throughout St. Louis City, and we'll be sending out throughout the county and other places. And we're asking you to just pray that the seed that's planted will bring forth new club members. We need new club members here at New Life Evangelistic Center. As I indicated, the need runs $13,000 to $15,000 a day. And we've been getting anywhere from, some days we get as little as two, and some days we thank God and we get eight or 10. But very seldom have we reached that amount. So how do we keep on doing? Well, the bills just keep mounting and mounting and mounting. We sold a radio station in Marshfield. We were able to use that money immediately just to pay off overdue bills. And here we are. The bills are there. We need a financial miracle at this time. But God is in the miracle-working business. And I ask you to please pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center and share that gift as the Lord has laid on your heart. And it's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Now, I know many of you are going through difficult times. Just knowing that you're praying is very important to us here. And if you'd like to share your prayer requests and just a note that you are praying, we welcome that also. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. And I thank God for each and every one of you. And you're making such a big difference for good. You are touching lives. Lives are being transformed through our resurrected Lord working through you.
Hello, my name is Benjamin Brown. I'm from Normandy, Missouri, and I'm here at New Life Evangelistic Center. I'm homeless, and we have no shelters at all out in St. Louis County. I was out on the streets, and I heard people talking about New Life. I came here. They asked no questions. They offered me a bed. They offered me food, shower. Didn't care where I came from or what my story was. They just welcomed me and a whole lot of other people's, and it's like an oasis in a sea of despair. They do it all by the grace of God and the wonderful people that help them. No government funds whatsoever. So if you out there, come to New Life, and if you can, please help them with anything you can. Donations, you know, anything that you can. It's a wonderful place. They're here for you. And you don't have to be out there on the streets. You don't have to be harassed or sleeping on the streets or anything.
Ben, did you experience some of that when
yes,
you were
homeless? Yes, sir, I have.
Tell us about you were sleeping out there in Normandy, and,
yes, sir.
And how were you harassed?
The police told me that you can't sleep in storefront, you can't sleep here, you can't sleep there, you got to get out of the county or they will arrest you.
Okay, and so the only shelter they provide Normandy is emergency housing in their jail.
Right.
You know, it is harassment.
Yes,
years
sir.
Ago, you know, we can look back in communities that if you were African American, they say you better get out of town or we'll lock you up. They
yes,
drove
sir.
The African American out of town now. Now they don't care what color you are. If you don't have any green in your pocket, they run you out of town if you're homeless.
Yes, sir.
I hear this story over and over and over. The police just will threaten you, they harass you, they'll lock you up, and ship you out of town.
Yes, sir.
So you had that happen to you?
Yes, sir. More than once.
Have you really? I've heard this over and over in stories from out in St. Louis County out there. And then when you try to open a shelter, they give you all kinds of trouble when you try to open a shelter.
Right.
In churches, they got to stop running scared. They just got to start opening doors, and they got to start banding together. And the people in the churches have to start going to these county council meetings and these city meetings and start saying, look, what are you going to do about the homeless in our city? You can't keep shoving them out of sight and out of mind, because they want to convince themselves there are no homeless in Normandy, or no homeless in Wellston, no homeless in University City, or wherever it may be, because I hear from every municipality out there, as long as they keep pushing them out, nobody will see them, and they think there's nobody there, and they don't do anything for them.
Right.
Something's wrong with that.
There's definitely something.
So how'd you hear about this place?
Through word of mouth, you know, I was walking around downtown, didn't know where to go, and I heard other homeless people say, well, you can go to Larry Rice's and they'll take you in, and this is 11 o'clock at night. I didn't think that you could go, because I had called the hotline and you have to have a referral or something like that. So I figured I didn't have a chance, but I came right up to the door and they welcomed me in.
And you know, and people, you hear this on these other newscasts on all the stuff the mayor of the city's doing and how he's got his network going. They don't tell you the full story. You know, they got the 10-year plan. But so many people don't qualify if they're not drug addicts and they're not alcoholics and not mental cases and you know, all this stuff that they get federal money for. And you're just an ordinary citizen, you're homeless, you fall through the cracks, you call the hotline, they don't have any room for you, and you're left out on the streets.
Right.
And you can testify to that, can't you?
Yes, sir.
And if somebody asks you, why is it important that they donate to New Life Evangelistic Center, to this place, what would you say to them?
Because there are a lot of people out here that need your help. If it wasn't for this center, the people, they just would be devastated. They wouldn't have any place to go. They would probably turn to drugs or something even worse. You never know. And all they need is 80 cents a day, $24 a month. You know, we spend more than that on junk food. So if you could find it in your heart to help Larry Rice's cause, please help him.
Well, you've heard it, folks. Straight from the people. I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center, and please do get involved. You can become a club member. It's so easy. Just send your first $24 gift and include a note, I want to become a Club 24 member. We just thank God for each and every one of you that do that. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. The Holy Spirit may have spoke to your heart to write out a check for $100, $500, even $1,000 or more. Please be obedient and share now. You can also give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. The need is great. People are coming in all hours of the night. We need a miracle. God is in the miracle working business, and I thank God for how he's working through his people, caring people like you and all of you that are doing your part. I just want to say thank you, and you're making a big difference in the lives of so many that are in need.